Welcome to the second production of our Camp Emerson Theater. Tonight, you'll get to enjoy Joseph and his amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. And to lead you into tonight's show will be tonight's director, Nikki Stern. Yeah.
You guys are all super excited to see the show. Everybody that's been a part of it has been doing an amazing job, working really, really hard. So please just give them your undivided attention. And I just want to give a really special thanks to Sophie Pankhurst. Woo! Sophie! Woo! Without her, this show would not have happened. She's really amazing, and she deserves that recognition. So I hope, Okay, so, all right, everybody, please enjoy the show.
The eye, a king would stop and stare.
And when
loss is not the kind of things we brothers wish to hear. It seems to us that Joseph and his goat should disappear.
One more tear in my eye, but Joseph.
no tear be shed. If he had not laid down his life, we all would now be dead. There's one more angel in heaven. There's one more star in the sky. Joseph will never forget you. It's tough, but we're gonna get by.
Thank you. fortune low. Alone he sat, alone he thought of happy times he used to know. Hey dreamer, don't be so upset. Hey Joseph, you're not beaten yet. Go, 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 Joseph, you know what they say. Hey, no, no, Joseph, you'll make it someday. Sha-la-la, Joseph, you're doing fine. You and your dream coat ahead of your time.
The prison walls were wet and black. The chains were heavy, weighed him down. The candle was his only light. The hungry rats, the only sound. Hey, dreamer, don't be so upset. Joseph, you're not beaten yet.
Go, 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 Joseph, you know what they say. Hang on now, Joseph, you'll make it someday. Sha-la-la, Joseph, you're doing fine. You and your dream coat ahead of your time.
The prison cell, in the prison cell with Joseph were two very frightened men.
We don't think that we will ever see the light of day again. Hey Joseph, help us if you can. We have dreams that we don't understand.
Both men were servants of Pharaoh the king. Doing their thing. One was a baker, the cook of his prime. One was a butler, the G's of his time.
Tell me all your dreams, my friends, and I will tell you what they show. Though I cannot guarantee to get it right, I'll have a go.
First the butler trembling took the floor. Nervously he spoke of what he saw.
There I was standing in front of a vine. I picked some grapes and I crushed them to wine. I gave them to Pharaoh, who drank from my cup. I tried to interpret, I had to give up.
So do not worry anymore. The king will etch you out of here. You'll bottle as you did before.
Next, the baker rose to tell his dream, hoping it would have a similar theme.
There I was standing with baskets of bread. High in the sky, I saw birds overhead who flew to my basket and ate every slice. Sad to say, your dream is not the kind of dream I'd like to get. Pharaoh has it in for you. Your execution day is set. Don't rely on all I said I saw. It's just that I have not been wrong before.
Go, 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 Joseph, you know what they say. Hey, go, go, Joseph, you'll make it someday. Sha-la-la, Joseph, you're doing fine. You and your dream coat ahead of your time.
The ancient world in the palm of his hand, to all intents. Thank you.
buddies, that's you and me. I was wise to have chosen. You'll be wise to agree.
This could be a happy ending, perfect place to stop the show. Joseph, after all, has gone about as far as he can go. But I'm sure that Jacob and his other sons have crossed their mind. How the family hit the family Joseph left behind.
Help me. song grows.